Also on Capitol Hill today, a partisan battle getting even uglier. It started with Iowa Democrat Rita Hart asked the Democratic-led House to investigate her November election loss. Her Republican challenger in the congressional race won by just 6 votes out of nearly 400,000. House Democrats agreed to investigate, but now House Republicans are crying foul, arguing that Democrats are trying to overturn the will of the voters, which is an argument that might have more credibility had the majority of House Republicans, including Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, not lied over and over about the election that Trump lost. CNN Chief Congressional Correspondent Manu Raju is live on Capitol Hill for us. And Manu, you had an extremely contentious exchange with McCarthy about this today, who was characteristically dishonest about his various efforts to overturn the election.
Yeah, I was trying to ask him how the situation involving this Iowa race in which Democrats are trying to overturn it in Congress is different than Donald Trump trying to overturn his election loss that Kevin McCarthy supported. But in a contentious exchange, he pushed back and engaged in a significant amount of revisionism, suggesting that what he was doing would not have overturned the election, even though he even signed on to a Texas lawsuit with 125 other Republicans that would invalidate millions of votes across several battleground states. And Republicans tried to object to 6 states and ultimately got votes on 2 of them, in which he supported throwing out those electoral results. He ultimately failed, but never Nevertheless, he did engage in revisionist history about everything that occurred in the run-up to January 6th.
The Iowa race. In your view, what is different between the efforts there to overturn the elections in the House versus Donald Trump's efforts to overturn the elections in Congress that you supported?
I disagree with the premise of your question. Okay. Mm-hmm. So if you challenged Arizona and Pennsylvania, would that have changed and lowered President Biden's numbers below 270?
You supported the Texas lawsuit.
You ask me questions every week. I just asked you a question. If you removed Arizona, but you weren't removing it, you were just asking the question about it. If Arizona and Pennsylvania were removed in the Electoral College, would President Biden's number lower below 270?
No, but Donald Trump said that Congress could have overturned the election.
I'm not Donald Trump. So you're asking me the question.
I'm answering your question.
Let me answer your question since you asked me. Let me follow through. So you gave a premise that's not true.
Donald Trump tried to overturn the results in Congress, and you support that effort.
Well, now you're saying something that's not true. So let me answer your question and show you how your premise is not true.
The losing candidate didn't organize a rally and say, stop the steal, we can overturn the certification of the Electoral College on January 6th.
Okay, do you want to talk to Trump or you want to ask me the question? Because I'm here right now, and I'm showing where your question doesn't hold merit. Now, let me show you another answer.
But you supported the Texas lawsuit, too. Do you regret supporting that lawsuit validated?
No, I don't. You know why? Because it's going to the court.
Or did you not support Donald Trump's effort to overturn the election in Congress?
Didn't we just answer this the first time you asked it? You even answered. How many electoral votes does it take to get to 270?
He's so dishonest. It's really flabbergasting. But one of the things that's so amazing here, Manu, is at first he argues that it was okay that he supported that insane Texas lawsuit that the Supreme Court just threw out and threw to the curb that would have completely overturned the election, taken away the votes of voters in Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Georgia, just given those states to Trump. And he says that that's okay that he did that because that's the right way to do this in courts. And then he justifies doing it not in courts, doing it in Congress. And yes, they only did 2 states and not 6 states that they were planning to do because there was a deadly insurrection. I mean, it's just maddening.
It is. And look, in the run-up to January 6th, I had asked McCarthy a number of times, would you consider Joe Biden the winner? He would not say. I said, do you have any concerns about what Donald Trump is doing here? He would not raise any concerns. And as part of that exchange, I tried to ask him, why didn't you raise concerns with what Donald Trump was doing? And he would not address that, instead suggesting opposite, that he was not trying to overturn the election when it was pretty clear what he was intending to do.
He's just so dishonest. It's just stunning. Manu Raju, thanks so much. Appreciate it.